G'day folks, Ben from Snowy's here today. I'm going to show you how to assemble the Oklahoma Joe's Rambler portable grill.
Hit it.
This is a compact griller or smoker that can be used in the backyard or small enough to even take camping. That's really easy to assemble and really good quality. So your Oklahoma Joe's Rambler comes in a box like this. It's about 57 by 44 centimeters by 47 centimeters in height, and the smoker itself weighs about 22 kilos. So whole package and everything here is somewhere between probably about 25 and 30 kilos. Now it's disassembled inside. We've got to put it together, which is obviously what we're showing you today. Now to get it out, it's probably a little bit much to lift it out the top here. So you might be able to get a friend to help you kind of lift this up and out, but it's probably easier. And what actually they recommend in the manual is just to cut down the corners here, flatten the box out, and then just pull the box out from underneath, which is what I'm going to do. And then I'll spread all the parts out to show you what comes inside. So I've unpacked everything in here, and all this is really well packed inside the box. It's either in a plastic bag or padded with polystyrene or cardboard or something, so it's all quite well packed. There's no scratches or anything on this. So the parts inside, you do get a few, get a user manual, a few books with it, user manual, which has got a heap of information, plus the assembly instructions that will follow shortly, a little bit of information on support and maintenance and preparation of your smoker. And you do also get a bit of a grilling guide here. Now, I'm not a griller, so I don't know all the details of this, but it gives you a basic outline of how to get started grilling, and you get some bonus stickers in there as well. So we won't need that one or these for today, but we will need our instruction manual shortly to put all these parts together. So just to run through what we've got here, this is the ash tray that goes in the very base of the griller here to catch all the ash once it's burnt. This is what actually holds the charcoal or the briquettes, and that's suspended by these inside, which will make more sense later. Got three handles, side handles and a front handle, little chimney stack here to control the amount of smoke that comes out of the unit, also a bit of heat control. This is will go on the side to control the airflow in the unit. Little lifter here that work in conjunction with the cast iron grill plates here, so you can lift these up without having to touch them if you need to remove them to add more charcoal. The lid over here, which is hinged by these little, these are the hinges here, they'll make more sense very shortly how that works. Your little temperature gauge that goes in the top of the lid here, and you get a box of nuts, bolts, screws, etc. that you need to assemble it, and these are labeled on the back. Exactly what their labels are, D, E, A, F, B, C, and that lines up with what's going on in here. So it tells you for this step here, for step number two, we need 8 B's and 8 C's. So it's all outlined in the manual here on what to do. So we'll start with step A, or the first step, which requires these things here to be attached to the main base, which is this bit over here. So to get started, I'm gonna tip the unit up with these hinged sides down, and I'm gonna face what will be the bottom of the unit towards me. Now, the instructions are telling me I need 8 B's and 8 C's. So we've got B, which is 8 here, and 8 C's. So I won't point this out at every step, but it's really easy to follow which ones you need here. So I'll get eight of them out. I need a screwdriver, Phillips head screwdriver, and an adjustable wrench or a spanner, whatever you like. That's going to be handy. You could probably get by without the wrench. And then I'm going to attach these on the side here. So the screw will go through here from the outside. The bolt will go on the inside. And these need to attach such that these points here are facing inwards. So it will go that way and that way. And these holes, we can see there's a larger gap at the bottom here because this is the foot section. So this needs to line up or be on the base side of the unit. So these holes line up with these holes. I put two in there, do the same on the other side, and we've got the legs on the unit. So I'm actually finding that just the screwdriver is enough so far. These do have, you can use an adjustable wrench or a spanner on this, but they've got kind of a grippy back on it. So if you just hold these with your fingers, they usually grip enough just to do it up with a screwdriver, so it makes it a little bit faster. So two more to put on this side, and that's the legs on. So we can now go to the next step. I'll tip this over. So this is the back of the unit facing us here. We need to grab these. These are E and D, which are a thinner sort of screw there with washers. So we need both of those, and they work in conjunction with these brackets here. The screw will go on the end of those, and we can put the lid on top now. So we rest this up on here, and we need to line these hinges up. And what's going to happen is these brackets, and we need to make sure we put these on the right way, both go in the same direction, with one of it's threaded, one of these ends is threaded, one isn't. So the threaded one actually goes through the bracket like this. Same on the other side. So we put this in the same way. Don't put it in this way. This is incorrect. It needs to go the same way so that the hinges sit and are gonna stop the lid from going too far. You can see they sit against the back there. So it means when this opens, they're both on the same angle and it's gonna stop the lid from opening too far. Now put the washer on the screw there. And this, or the bolt, sorry. And this screws in here. Quite a long thread. And that's gonna lock this bracket in place. So we'll do the same on the other side. I'll just tweak that up a little bit. You don't need to do this too tight. If you did the nuts on the side too tight, you'd probably start to bend the metal, but that's gonna hold in place there. That's the first one. This is the second one. This one's a little bit awkward to get in because it's not a lot of room to work with. So they're tightened up in there now. We can see now if I open this lid why those hinges need to be on the same way, because they stop this lid from opening too far. Now we can spin the whole unit around and we're going to put some things in the top of the lid here. The first one of them being the smokestack. Now this pushes in from underneath here. It doesn't attach from the top. We push it through this hole here and into place. There's three mounting holes there. And we need three, what they label as A, which is a slightly shorter screw, and then three more of the nuts that we had before to secure that in place. So that's the smokestack in place. We're now going to put the handle on, which is these four mounting holes on the front here. We've signed up with the four mounting holes on the rubber handle here. So there's three handles that come with it. There's a rubber one and two metal ones. These metal ones are the side ones. This is the one that goes on the front. And you can tell which way up it goes because there is a logo here, the Oklahoma Joe's logo there, but to give you a better idea of the orientation, that's the shape of the handle and it goes on this way. If we put it on the wrong way around it, it just kind of looks a bit funny, it's sticking up in the air. So that goes on this way, four screw holes with the same nuts and bolts that we used for the smokestack. So that's all done with the handle and the smokestack there now. Well, we're going to put the temperature gauge in. Now there is a specific warning with this temperature gauge, which goes in, this is already a threaded hole here, but they do specifically say not to tighten it by holding on to this part here, obviously because you could break it or wreck the mechanism, but there is a nut on here that you can use with your adjusting spanner to tighten down against it. So we'll screw this in, and what this also allows you to do is adjust where this sits. So if you look at the top here, if I tighten that up to where it is now, it's sideways. But if I just play around with this screw underneath here, move that back a little bit so that it's straight, and then tighten the screw underneath, we can get this straight. I can use this to tighten this against the lid there while the thermometer is sitting straight. It's just a little bit off. I'm just going to adjust that a little bit there so that it's nice and straight. So right now I'm not using this to tighten it. I'm just tightening the nut underneath against the body. You don't need to over tighten it, just firm. So that's nice and secure in place there now. Okay, next step is to attach the vent on the side here, or the airflow adjuster on the side here. So we need two F-bolts, they call this, which are little rounded head bolts with a bit of a buffer. The screw, the thread doesn't go right to the top, and that allows it to sit in this channel here and for this to slide back and forward, because this is going to go on here and allow you to open and close the vent on the side here. So we need to get two of these, two of the same nuts that we've used before. So one of these will go at one end through the, oops, through the vent there, and then through the hole in the body of the smoker. Same on the other side here. And these two nuts, while we're holding it in place, go on the inside. So I'm gonna have to open the lid again to reach inside here and do these up. Now these aren't gonna do up tight against the metal because it needs to allow a bit of movement for the vents to slide back and forward. So you can always just do these up finger tight, really. So I am just going to tighten this up a bit with a screwdriver. It's already firm in this one. So even though they feel tight, it's still not firm enough to stop this from sliding back and forward there. So that's exactly how that's supposed to be set up. And the last step for the last of the nuts and bolts that are left here is to put the handles on. So we've got these two side handles. Now they're going to go on so that this they fit up this way, not this way, but up this way. And they actually screw into these mounting holes that are in the legs that we attached earlier. Now this kind of fits firmly in here, just requires a little bit of coercion just to get them lined up, not a lot, but everything else is lined up so far. And this is no exception, apart from just requiring a little bit of muscle just to get that lined up. Now we line these bolts up. They're all pre-threaded inserts in the legs there. So these screw straight into those legs. So this is mounted, the handle's actually mounted to these strong legs on the side, not to the sheet metal on the side. So it makes for a sturdier handle to carry the weight of the unit. So four screws on each side, tighten them up with a Phillips head screwdriver, and that's the handles attached. So that's all the nuts and bolts. That's now empty now. This unit here, we've used all of the nuts and bolts that we need to assemble it. So last few things to get it all set up. Open the lid again and grab these racks here. Now these are going to form part of the height adjustable tray for the charcoal that we have inside. To put these in place, the loop side is the handle that needs to stick up the top. We lay this down like this and hook these loops in the holes on the side there. Flip it right over backwards, and you just need to kind of go back and forward a little bit here until you get to that point there. Now don't go all the way. You need to allow this space here for hands to lift this up. And this is actually going to form the height adjustment for the charcoal tray inside. So we put one of those on each side. And now we've got a couple of trays to put inside. So the first, this black one, which goes right down in the bottom here. Now this is the ash tray that's going to catch all the burnt ashes from the charcoal that we're cooking with. So we push that all the way in there. And the second tray is the actual part where the charcoal or the briquettes are going to go. Now we push this right inside the unit here, so lower it right down to the bottom. And so before I do that, I'll just show you, it's got two hook points here on each side, another one on this side here. They line up with the hooks on the little brackets that we just placed inside the unit. So if you put this right down to the bottom, lay it on the bottom and lift up one side and just locate these hooks into that tray there. Do that on both sides. So this is actually suspended inside the smoker here. So that's now swinging there, and we can now adjust the height of it with these side bits here. So you see that goes up and down. The last thing to do is to put the cast iron grill plates in the top here. So these just sit on this ledge here, two of them. You can use the little tool here if you like to lower it in. Probably only really relevant when it's actually hot, but that sits in between there, and you can put the grill plate down in there like that. So that is now all set up. We can adjust this while the grill plate's in there. So if we want it up higher, cook hotter, down lower. That is how you assemble the Oklahoma Joe's Rambler portable grill. Now it's 20 something kilos, it's not a light unit. Portable if you've got a nice big truck to take it to the campsite, but whatever the case, it suits that kind of outdoor lifestyle. And if you want to smoke or grill in the backyard, it's a great option. Easy to assemble. Check them out online at snowys.com.au, where you find them at our lowest prices every day. But if you do have any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for our latest and greatest information, or check out some other awesome cooking products like this one down here.